Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to the ESL One Philippine qualifiers here for the Manila event that's going to be taking place later on in April. I'm Lyrical Dota, joined today by Mount Pax. We're going to be taking a look at a match here between TNC Pro Team facing off against Phoenix in what should be an absolutely fantastic game. Cannot wait for this one. Mount Pax, how are you doing? Are you excited about this game here?
Yeah, glad we're back, you know. Classic, just a couple of issues, but it's all right. Everyone's loading in now. We're already well underway. We got the lone druid snagged up by Phoenix, who, of course, we don't know too much about. Another qualifying team, but our qualifying team from the last one did win. However, much tougher opponent this time. It's not so much the extremists, a little bit less known team. Obviously, this is TNC Pro Team. You know, these guys, they compete on the highest level in the SCA scene, facing up against Fnatic all the time. Of course, like Mineski and plenty of the other Southeast Asian squads, even MVP Phoenix, who they took quite a few games off lately. I think they went 2-1 or actually ended up being 3-2 in favor of them. So either way, you know, I'm expecting a lot of TNC for this one.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, certainly expectations are high. And both of these squads, I feel like Phoenix, they're one of the teams that's kind of been around. Of course, this is an MVP Phoenix that, you know, built up such a storm around that last major in Shanghai. But this is a team that has competed in a lot of other events around this region. They've been around for a while. And because of that, we got a little bit more information about them than we did about our previous team, who actually ended up taking it, as you mentioned. And they are also very much one of the very fast tempo type of heroes or type of players. That being said, they did go for that lone druid first, which isn't necessarily what that hero is completely known for. More often than not, going instead, oh my goodness, never mind, I take it all back. We're going to be seeing the lone druid into Nature's Prophet, Vengeful Spirit, and then the Chen picked up. So no real surprise there. One of the strongest pushing lineups that you can potentially start up against another very strong pushing lineup. And man, picks coming fast and furious here. Drow banned out the Enchantress as well as the Tinker. A lot of interesting picks.
Yeah, it must be a Tinker player, I guess, on the squad of Phoenix. Usually you only see that like up against Van or something over in the NA region. But the Drow ban, Enchantress ban, no surprise there, obviously. Enchantress, great counter to Chen. Decent against the Bear as well for helping chunk him down later with the Impetus. And then the Drow, something TNC and most of these Asian squads are willing to wipe out, especially with the Nature's Prophet and Eventual Spirit opening. With the OD banned out, there's still a couple of those mid laners left, some of the bigger ones. The PL, still on the lookout, definitely one of the biggest ones for TNC that comes to mind for me. And then something to combo with their Sven. Like, they got the Nature's Prophet in the offlane, so you're not really looking for the Faceless Void or, like, your Tidehunter or anything. I think a little bit of, like, maybe a controlling mid into a Sven, or possibly even, like, a mid Gyro into a Sven, and they do all kinds of fun stuff.
Yeah, no, and I think that the fact that it's that open, you know, it really means that you have to be prepared for whatever they happen to throw at you, and it makes them that much more dangerous. I will say for Phoenix, I feel like the Lone Druid Chen pick kind of hems them into a particular playstyle. Oh man, he made it through. Oh god, we didn't even talk about him. Well, Earth Spirit is going to be played this time around and not opted to be banned out. Here's my question for you. If you don't have like a sort of dedicated Earth Spirit player where people are going to be banned out in the first round, is it still a hero that's strong enough that it's worth taking, like just because of what it's capable of doing, even if you're not sort of like known for being able to play it to its fullest potential? 10 seconds
remaining. Oh, yeah. I mean, for sure. It's just like such an insane hero. All you have to do is hit the roll. It's an 80% slow. After that, it's pretty much it. I don't even think it's reached the point where, like, you've seen so many pro games that I don't even think he's that mysterious of a hero anymore. Like, these guys are watching a lot of replays, like, shouldn't be too much of a concern. And now you have to be a little bit worried as Phoenix. Like, who are you going to send to the mid lane? Do you end up sending, like, the lone druid just because you're more worried about the pressure he's going to get?
Radiant. Yeah, that's kind of the question that I guess I would be struggling with as well. Again, like, the problem with that, though, is that Lone Druid is strong in lane, but that's as long as LD himself is not caught out. Like, if he is the one who's in trouble, if he's the one that gets rolled in on, he's not very tanky himself. It's mainly that bear, so the bear kind of has to tank the rolling boulder ganks. I guess that Savage Roar is always going to be there, so that's some way to make it work a little bit, but regardless, it's going to be a pretty interesting a pretty interesting draft. The Beastmaster was also taken, and then going back for that Sven that you were talking about, followed up by the Bane. I like Bane as an answer to Sven as a hero. It feels like it works pretty well. Just about the only thing that's better than it is that Nature's Prophet, which obviously we saw work really well throughout the whole course of that last major as well.
Yeah, and the Bane, pretty good for helping out in the mid lane too. Can make some rotations, some saves. With that Beastmaster as well, one thing to mention would be the fact that this Lone Druid is either going to the mid or the safe lane more than likely. But they still have a lot of potential for early push, and then the Viper ban out. Oh, hmm. Yeah. Is this like a mid Sven? What if...
TNC are one of the few teams that actually run Viper themselves, so prioritizing that hero a little bit more than a lot of other heroes. Gyrocopter also going to be taken out of the pool. That's their second most played hero on the side of TNC. I think it's like around 11 games or something crazy like that. But that and Venge are they play it a whole heck of a lot. Mr. Raven knows how to handle that hero, and we'll see what it ends up being. I guess that was sort of the worry of maybe being the mid gyro. It feels like Raven's probably going to be on the Sven then. Interesting.
I kind of like a safe lane slider or something here, honestly. 10 seconds remaining. Something that they need a little bit more control, it kind of feels like. Like, you already have the Stormhammer, yes, but you're lacking a lot of, that nice chase down potential, the initiation. Slider is really good against the bear with the minus armor. You don't really get the whole cleave potential that you get out of Sven for, like, dealing with the Chen creep and everything like that, but the counter initiation potential can really never be, like, underrated on that hero. And more AoE is just always going to be benefiting them.
They could go back for Quap or something like that as well. Oh, really?
All right, they did this in two games the other day, or maybe it was only one game. It did end up like running over the early stages. They still lost both games. I think it was AU went for a Midas Chen. It was brutal. I was casting both of them. It was pretty hilarious. And those were both against Fnatic, in which TNC did get 2-0'd, but it will be the mid Jacaro, so the push is strong.
Yeah, this is it's definitely a very well-defined draft as far as what it's going to try to do. And, you know, it always is a worry when you've got that Sven as sort of the solo core in the late game. Like, those BKB charges start running a little bit low, and already, you know, two heroes that deal really effectively with BKBs, with the Beastmaster and the Bane there. Obviously, Bane does have a lot of issues in this game. Jakiro there, Earth Spirit, as well as Ventral Spirit, and, you know, just getting a right click down as well, which could be an issue. But regardless, it's something that, you know, Sven's going to have to contend with. And as those BKB charges start rolling down, he runs into some issues. As a fifth pick right now, do you try and double down on the push? Do you try and get a little bit more control? Slow Siege, Roshan taking capabilities? Oh, they go back for the control.
Yeah, it makes sense with the Beastmaster and the Lone Druid. Lacking maybe what one consider a little bit of physical damage. Like, it's only essentially the Lone Druid. Might need some pretty big items come up on ice, get that really quick Necro Book. And very early game-centric lineup. Like, you look and you say, like, Sven's the only late game TNC have, but honestly, it's kind of the same thing with the Lone Druid in a lot of ways. So fairly even through most of the game, I think, here.
Yeah. Well, I might let you do the intros for both of these squads here while I try and sort out a few last-minute things, which, of course, are always lovely to take care of.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's the funnest stuff to do. So, well, on the dire side, TNC, the more known squad here. It's going to be Raven on the Sven. Teehee going to be on that mid-Jakiro that we're all excited to see. It'll be Winter G, Small Sun on the support Vengeful Spirit, the Young Sensation, and then Sam H going to be on his famous Nature's Prophet, probably his favorite hero to play, it seems, lately. And then AU, your captain and drafter, on the Roaming Earth Spirit. On the side of Phoenix, they have shown up here, the qualifying squad. It's going to be Ice on the offlane Beastmaster. It will be LYC on the Chen. Verzi on your Lone Druid. It's going to be Alodia on the Puck. Bogzy on the Bane to round it all out here. And both teams just going to group up with the runes. Ooh, they lose that early Hawk, a little bit of free gold. Get that early last hit before the horn. Feeling good on that mid Jakiro. Pretty much GG in the lane now with that extra 25 EXP. That's it, man, you know.
That's pretty much all it takes. Yeah, absolutely. It's some lovely stuff when you end up being able to make it work. And looks like they're going to put themselves in a pretty good position here. Get into place with the runes. And Phoenix just going to be able to take down this bottom one here for the Puck. So as far as lane setups goes, where do you think we're going to see the Earth Spirit do, like, the most amount of his damage here?
Well, they've gone for the traditional thing of just throw puck in the mid lane and then you won't die to Earth Spirit. That's the general plan, so it's going to have to be somewhere else. They have the early ward up because they're assuming it's going to be the top lane, but they looks like they did spot this out from the side of TNC, so they should know there's a ward there. In fact, AU might be on his way to take care of it now, or just block this off as well. But it should just be the top lane. Honestly, Beastmaster's like the only one they can kill. Not going to get the lone druid with a Bane nearby. And so if they can pull this wave back, maybe they can get him a couple times over.
Yeah, it's kind of the hope and goals, I guess. It's, none of that pull camp was blocked out. They're going to put him in a little bit of a precarious situation. And it's worth noting that, you know, obviously when you have Beastmaster, he's an incredibly strong laning hero. It's hard for Ventral Spirit to actually zone this out with the double boar slow going on, even at the early levels, and should have trouble trading hits. Oh man, this is going to do a lot of damage here. Creeps are chasing. And yeah,
he knows the Earth Spirit's there though.
Need to be a runaway. They're thinking about going on this now. Maybe going to be able to make it happen. Now they're calling it off. Interesting.
We already have the early tornado coming to mid lane on Teehee. And this lane's already pretty difficult early on. Like, your one way to really zone on Elodia, of course, is going to be that liquid fire spam. But at the higher cooldowns, it's really likely he's going to have phase shift ready and available. Like, he won't have traded a right click or anything like that. Now, that is one benefit, right? Because you can basically always just keep right clicking the puck as the Jakiro and assume that he's not going to phase shift dodge. And he does have the extra damage. This tornado is just making it so good.
Yeah, that is really good. Yeah, you mentioned the damage there. I mean, it's worth noting the way that Jakiro has gotten changed, that the most recent patch giving him the higher base damage too, it helps him out a lot. It's been able to make him into a not... I still don't think he's like a great mid hero by any means at all, but it's possible to do that now, and you see a lot of damage gain trade back. He's trying to do something to Teehee here, but the slow damage over time, the puck's going to be taken. It's hard to deal with.
Goodness. Yeah, he made that mistake that I wasn't expecting.
Oh, phase shift, but they still end up being able to get the rolling bullet forward. Oh, that wasn't quite a kill on Teehee.
Goes survives. For the buyback.
Oh my goodness, really? He ended up being able to go for the buyback? Oh, what a guy. Is he going to die for it, though? Is he actually going to be able to get away with that? They end up being able to get the silence off the rotation. Oh, they end up finding the kill. But man, that was some sneaky stuff.
Yeah, I've been seeing that. I guess it's just because Puck's back. I've been seeing it quite a bit lately. Everyone's like, oh yeah, you can do that. And it's worse than those first early engagements, but not if you're going to die for it. So now he's like the extra delay of coming back into the lane. And he made that mistake, though. Like, he used phase shift to dodge a single right click from the Jakiro. And then that just means immediately, all right, I am going to liquid fire you the second you come back out of that. And you saw how much damage it did to him.
Yeah, that was pretty ridiculous. I saw one other instance of that earlier. It was with a Puck and a Chen, which, interestingly enough, is up in this game again.
Oh, that one's good, yeah.
Where you go for the, QW? I don't know what's going on. Anyways, you go for the Illustri Orb, and then you end up being sent back right at the same time, and then you end up being able to, you know, obviously Ethereal Jaunt back into the fight, so that way your bottle's filled up afterwards. But bottom lane, they get the Nightmare down here onto the Nature's Prophet, going to be able to do a decent chunk of damage looking for Root. They get the Body Block, though. Going to be able to do a ton of damage here. I don't think it's going to be enough. They do end up being able to find him, though, and that's going to be another kill. So back and forth we go, 2-3 so far. Pretty very intense game.
Yeah, it looks like Bogsy got just the right timing there where the treants were on cooldown, so he was able to get that Nightmare on there, and usually it's very difficult to deal with the Nature's Prophet because he just takes it off with one of the treants, but caught him when he didn't have any, and that allows an easy kill for them. Looks like top lane Ice will be able to get this rune here. Question is, it looks like he'll just have to take it, though. Oh!
He still picked
close
it up.
Close one.
That was nice. I mean, those are the plays that you hope to be able to make as Earth Spirit. Maybe you kick the guy up to the high ground or something like that, but it's not always the easiest to do. So still getting the rune. And it's worth noting, like, if you look at the net worths right now, it's still very early in the game, but you can already see the power of that early laning stage and a couple of the kills. The Lone Druid currently up on top, but then four heroes, including that roaming Earth Spirit, is ahead of pretty much everybody else on the side of the Radiant.
Calm.
I wonder if they're actually going to be able to get ice here.
Roll.
Nope.
Yeah, that'll happen. It's fine, though. you look for those moments to be able to find somebody, and it's really just about putting the fear in them. I mean, you'd love to be able to find the kill, but it's not always the most important thing in the world, more just the other stuff. As they do end up being able to find a kink down in the bottom lane, and man, the double Centaur's Thump, as well as two Roots, there was no way that Nature's Prophet was ever escaping from that one. So on the one side, one offlaner dodges the gank, the other one gets taken out by it. A little bit frustrating.
Time to avoid that lane.
Yeah, this is going to be the pressure. The Spirit Bear is there. They're going to be able to kill us pretty quickly.
I kind of want to see, like, they have this nice vision here on ice, and obviously he's jungling up. He's going to be here a little while. I want to see AE, like, quickly rotate for, like, a roll-in with the TP from Sam H, but instead he's going to use it to go bot, and he's also gone for the heavy stat build, double nulls and the bracer.
They've got the two centaurs here. Seeing the TPs in, though, they're going to try to escape, and this is a lot of creeps here that are probably going to end up going down. They get the stun off, which means it's denied out by the tower, and they're not going to be able to find the last hit on that centaur. So the escape happens. They're able to save their tower for now, and that's really important. Had they lost their offlane tower this early in the game, it would have been a problem. Well, as you mentioned, the right clicks come, and Sven ends up being able to finish them off. A nice little play there. Stormhammer committed.
Yeah, that's surprising they're able to get that, honestly. Like, you gotta know, you're still level 3, and the Sven's level 6, so he just waltzes right up there. If you come within range of one of their stuns, you're just dead. not much to it, you know? Not exactly the calculations or trigonometry coming out.
Oh, absolutely. Oh. Resummon on the bear? One thing I'm kind of curious about here, and it's something that I've seen several times. Normally, it's a Chen in conjunction with another mech-carrying hero, as we are going to see a little bit more pressure in the mid lane as the trades continue to go. Is you end up going for something along the lines of, like, another hero picking up the mech, Chen rushes the Ags, and then you can have, like, the Frenzy bonus attack speed on Spirit Bear, which can be so freaking effective in the mid-game.
Yeah, with the way that this game's going, like, it is a mid-jack hero, so it's kind of like maybe they're just thinking, oh my god, is he going to get his kill? Fairy Fire at the burns? No, not enough.
That was really close. I thought you were talking about the bottom one where we are going to see Bogsy go down, I believe. The bear is there as well, but that was just a resummon. It's going to be gone for 72 seconds, and now it looks like LD is going to go down as well. Can they find the kill on the Bane? He's still alive for the moment. Brainstaff's available. He actually ends up just turning around and killing off the Vengeful Spear, but the Nature's Prophet takes his turn as well. JYC completely hemmed around in by these Treants, and he is going to fall with the Sprout. Triple kill for the Nature's Prophet at 7.5 minutes in. 4-7 the current score, and
he's so
rich. My goodness, that is a quick turnaround for somebody who had a rough offlane.
Yeah, just goes home, buys himself a fresh set of drums, some bongos. They love these things, man. You get like triple drums on TNC. Like, I thought dual drums was intense. These guys, though, and they're not afraid to bring out the band.
Absolutely.
And it really is a marching band, I suppose, because they do really just start like grouping up, and yeah, they're building them up on the Jakiro as well.
Nice. Could say they march to the beat of their own drum. All right, we're done with that.
One might say.
Picking up the Arcane Rune as well. So, going to be able to spam out those spells all the more frequently, which is always nice to get on those sort of tempo-y type of mids. They throw on out a couple more of those Illusory Orbs, and you can see on a crazy low cooldown, can do a little bit of damage to the tower, then back out. It's interesting, we've seen the Beastmaster still stick around, but Bane is rotated here as well, trying to find a kill onto the Sven if he sticks a little bit too far out. Can they really get this though without level 6 on Bane? I feel like it's going to be too hard.
I feel like they're just hoping a support's going to show up, honestly.
Yeah.
And try and help with the Sven or something.
Lone Druid goes down again.
That's big.
That is huge. That was also, he resummoned again, so that's another 95 seconds with no bear. Even when he does get up in 20 seconds. This is, he was top of the mark for a while there. That's huge.
That means Midas is well off in ice. Stormhammered. God strength.
Oh, man. Yeah, he ends up being able to get the Fairy Fire, but they're rolling Boulder in again. They do get him, but it's, this has been an odd game. Man, they take down the bottom tier 1 tower. TNC are on a freaking roll. They are everywhere across the map right now, and it just doesn't feel like Phoenix have the answer.
Now they just keep picking them off, like, one by one. And to slow down that puck in the mid lane, honestly, that buyback hurt him so much.
Yeah.
Like, he's so far away from getting to that Blink Dagger, and because that's not really there, there's no serious initiation. And Teehee's just, like, soloing towers as a Jakiro. Yeah. They're coming up top, though. They have that Drink Pool, and they want to use it.
This would be so big if they could find a kill, but they need to get the proper initiation. The tower already falls down. Obviously, the 2 points in Warcry just giving all of those creeps that extra bit of survivability, and everywhere you're looking right now, I mean, it's just, it's Phoenix responding to the pressure that TNC are trying to place, and they're too late every step of the way. By the way, Lone Druid is maybe going to die again down here. No, they're not going to be able to find that one, but he brought down to half HP. He ended up going to true form. Still 15 seconds with no bear. The puck is going to be able to chase him on down now. This should finally be a kill, as they do end up being able to kill off that Nature's Prophet. Currently the highest net worth in the game. And yet again, a reminder that that is the offlaner that died twice before the 7 minute mark, who's now been able to just build up his net worth again. So a real testament to the stick-to-itiveness of that guy on that hero.
Oh, mid lane, they got Sheehy as well with the net.
Silence down, a secondary net gonna fly. They end up being able to get the magic missile off. Centaur stop does go through.
Nice kick.
Really well played there. The turnaround macro pyre, tons of damage onto the chin. He ends up going down. A lot of people standing in the fire, but still okay for the moment. Turnaround Fiend's Grip onto Raven. He's dropping low, but they're gonna kill off the Bane and Ice trying to get out of there. They're gonna be able to do a ton of damage to the buck. Phase shifts away. Can they find it? Spocked in by his own Sprout. Not something that you see all that often, but Constellation Prizes, tier one tower, and soon to be a tier two as well. Man, TNC are on a freaking roll. Huge team fight after team fight.
Yeah, I mean, that was like by the pixel. That puck didn't get caught inside. He kind of got pushed forward by the Sprout and had to blindly throw it there from Sam H. But it's all right. They end up just getting quick two towers. And, oh, he actually is going to grab the Dragon Lance. All right. I guess he feels like they're going high ground. I was kind of liking the Orchid idea with the quarterstaff, just because, you know, this puck's so far behind. It's going to be a while.
Yeah, it's interesting. I do kind of like the idea of going back for that Orchid that you were talking about, but maybe feeling like this stuff comes online a little bit more quickly. Eventually, he's going to want to, you know, build into a BKB, and then afterwards maybe the Orchid, or possibly he goes for the Orchid first and then the BKB. But regardless, both of those, you know, abilities really translate well into it, and being able to up that attack range to 730 is just so ridiculously good. And now we're seeing Phoenix move on in. They want to take a tower of their own, but can they actually do it? Swap is
they
up.
They have magnetize.
Oh,
you need to be careful.
So scary. Again, it's just it's such a terrifying. Oh, they get the stomp off. They're going to be able to catch. Oh, God, the puck. He's going to go down. He ends up being able to get the phase shift, but magnetize is still there. Able to phase shift away a second time from the storm hammer, but he's going to go down there. Macro pyre now blocking off their retreat. Ice and everybody has to run through it. They're slowed down. They're going to all fall down as well. The bear dies, and it looks like Ice is going to go down. Four dead on the side of Phoenix and TNC. My goodness, this is a stomp if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, they just, it kind of looked like they had the right positioning, but that silence coming on top of the puck, like, a little bit too forward, I think. Until you have the blink dagger, though, that's how you have to play it. And you don't have that nice counter initiation, that's the way you always want to be engaging as a puck. And, again, they're just getting run over. These towers are melting, they'll be back up soon, but what do they have to throw at them?
Exactly, and, I mean, at this point, I do feel like probably Phoenix's lineup scales a little bit better than TNC's, just because of that lone druid and then also having the sort of, you know, the backup. Beastmaster late game with that inner beast aura and all of the Chen creeps can really be effective. Again, Sven's a monster, so I don't know. It's kind of a wash to me, but I don't think that right now TNC are in any crazy hurry. It's like, you know, the 45-minute mark where we're talking about it. And honestly, at this point, lone druid, he's below the Jakiro. But the one thing that I am kind of a little bit curious about, oh god, Phoenix, oh, silenced up again. There's going to be another huge combo coming out, magic missile, and the puck goes down. You know, when we saw there in the mid lane, it felt like the puck didn't even see the centaur creep that was just walking up to him, and it was able to get a stun off with the initiation, and then Earth Spirit just followed up with everything. Like, I don't know, maybe just too much stuff on the map at once or something.
Well, Roshan, also another great benefit of the Jakiro. Pretty easy to take down. They can just move in there. They've got 2 points in the aura. I really like this Ventral Spirit build when they're G-Small Sun too. Like the 3-2-2, just understanding like these early points, they do a lot.
Yeah, I appreciate the build as well. Probably for less analytical reasons than you do. You're the guy with all the answers.
I actually didn't catch that at all until I said it. I had no idea that was about to come out of my mouth, so it was kind of funny.
Absolutely. Well, Tier 1 tower ends up dropping in the top lane, so they've taken two and actually three so far. kind of pressuring a bit further. It's worth noting, you know, you got Shen, you got Beastmaster. They take towers rather quickly, especially with the even just that 1 point in the inner Radiant's Beast Store. 15 bonus attack speed, ain't nothing to sneeze at. And starting to take a tier 2 tower of their own, TNC, not to be outdone. And now with Aegis, man, they need to get back. This is a lot of creeps.
Yeah, that's all right. They all do have TPs. I was kind of half expecting someone not to, just out of, you know, sheer hilarity. Nature's Prophet, he'll head home for now. But he's got the TP back in. Do they have any bottles? He's been filling them up this whole time. Yeah, he can just, like, TP right onto AU and fill his bottle. Such a nice treat, Nature's Prophet.
Yeah.
Such a sweetheart.
It's good stuff. They also have the courier coming on, and Sanj completed for Mr. Spen. So that Sanj and Yasha completely done. Well, Ice Path turned back around. Able to get the stuns off. Oh, several now. Gonna be able to do a lot of damage to the bear, but the Savage Roar keeping him down for the moment. Aegis still hasn't popped. A Blink Dagger, by the way, is up on Jakiro. They've already taken the Tier 3 tower. They get the Liquid Fire damage off, kills off the Centaur. Bear is still taking a ton from it with the Veil already completed, and the right clicks are still flying. They end up being able to take back over. Oh, they took over the Siege Creep, or the Dark Troll Summoner with the Helm of the Dominator. Now they got one of their own. Trying to turn this back around. They throw out the Wild Axes, but it doesn't feel like TNC are ever going to stop. Do they end up being able to find anything here? They take back over the Dark Troll Summoner again. Up, turn back around. Really good play there. It is going to end up being the Nature's Prophet going down, it looks like. Can they finish him off? He does go down. Counter initiation coming in, though. Ice is going to drop. He does fall. The two swipes there from the Sven. Fiend's Grip turning around. They do end up having the Puck, Illusory Orb through it all.
Ice Path. Oh, nice Ice Path.
And then we're going to be able to bring him down. Buyback by this Vayne, and I don't even know. This is so freaking bad right now. They get a huge amount of damage off with the Silence coming out, but are going to be able to kill off the Vayne. That's a dieback right now at 16 minutes. Another huge Ice.
Oh my god, he's
the
dead.
And everything else committed. Triple kill for TNC. This is such a big problem. Oh man, and the barracks done at 17 minutes. Man, Pop Hacks, they are so freaking good right now.
Yeah, they were just not ready for that Jakiro. He just turned the aggression up to 10, and also just, you know, getting outplayed. Clearly, you know, extremely talented squad coming out here from TNC. There's that Orchid. He did disassemble too, so no more Dragonlance.
Everybody's dead. Yeah, they don't even care. They want the Dragonlance. They want the Orchid. They want everything, and they get it all. They did disassemble it, you said. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. I don't know even what to say at this point. He gets the Nightmare off, which is probably the best thing that they can possibly hope for. Brain Sap turned back around. They kick forward the Jakiro, but GG got called. Apparently, we ended up missing that one. I didn't see it get called. Oh, there it was. But yeah. TNC take game number one in very convincing fashion. We'll see what ends up happening in game two. But Montpax, what are your thoughts? How do you stop this?
I don't know. I guess the mid lane, right? Like, the fact that Jakiro, he's not exactly the biggest lane dominator. He is not in a 1v1 scenario, but you got to bring some people in. Got to get that Chen up there, get the creeps coming in, try and put some pressure there. And we talked so much about, like, the lane the Earth Spirit was going to have an impact on, but what about the Chen, like, trying to get something done, trying to help out your little Jakiro? Typically, Puck want to be, like, doing A-OK, then you hit 6, there's a rotation in, you get a kill with the Dream Coil, and that's kind of what starts the start snowballing you into that Blink Dagger, into the Dagon, into the Yules, and so on and so forth. So, coming to the next draft, I think Phoenix maybe trying to get something a little bit more... like maybe two lane supports, honestly. Like, if the Chen's not going to rotate and do stuff, he didn't really get much done this game. I wouldn't mind just seeing a little bit safer and sturdier lanes as opposed to the full greed of Lone Druid plus Chen.
Yeah. No, I'm with you. That definitely felt like it was the type of opening that you kind of have to be able to build stronger lanes out of. And Bane is pretty strong. Beastmaster can be strong. But it felt like they're... Like you said, you know, so much ride or dies on that Puck and his ability to get off to a good early start. And it with that buyback, it kind of struggled there towards the beginning and sort of throughout the whole rest of the game. Maybe also thinking about banning out Earth Spirit. Just saying, if you get him in the third pick, that's pretty good value there. Regardless, we're going to be back in just a second with Game 2 of TNC facing off against Phoenix. Hope you guys enjoyed Game 1. We'll be back in just a couple of seconds here. Yet again, this is the ESL One Manila Philippines qualifiers. See you guys in just a second.